Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are discussing about the problem solving methods on trust elements. Before going to this lecture, please like, share and subscribe my channel. The problem is, for the trust element shown in figure, complete the following. First one, determine the element stiffness matrix for each element. Next is assemble the structural stiffness K matrix for the entire truss. Next one, using elimination approach, solve the nodal displacement, then recover the stresses in each element. Next, calculate the reaction forces. In this problem, what may have find means element stiffness matrix for the each element, element stiffness matrix for the each element, and global stiffness matrix means assemble the structural stiffness. Okay, next nodal displacements, displacement at each node. Next, stresses in the each element. Okay, this is the figure given in the problem. There is a three supports here. This is the truss element diagram. First of all, we have to indicate the number of elements. Here this is the element number one, hence we indicate the number one inside the circle. Then this is the element number two, this is the element number three, this is the element number four. Okay, in that problem they mentioned that in the question itself they mentioned the nodal numbers and element numbers and displacement numbers. If the numbers are not given in the problem, you should indicate this element numbers and nodal numbers. Okay, then this is the node number one, this is the node number two, this is the nodal number three, this is the nodal number four. Okay, then this is the displacement in horizontal direction, means q1, this is q2, vertical direction q2. q3 and q4 are the displacements, horizontal and vertical displacements at node 2 respectively. Similarly, the q5 and q6 displacements at node 3. Next, q7 and q8 are the horizontal and vertical displacements at node 4 respectively. Okay, then there is a supports at node 1, node 4 and node 3. These are the fixed supports. Okay, there is no movement in horizontal or vertical from at node 1 and node 2, but here at node 2 there is a roller support. There is no vertical displacement here. Okay, there is a horizontal movement because of the rollers. Okay, so the displacement in horizontal direction is present at node 2, but there is no vertical movement, means net vertical displacement, there is no vertical displacement. Okay, then the length of the first element is 40 meter and the length of the distance between two supports is 30 meters. Okay, then this 30 is equal to length of the second element, and this is the length of the first element is 40 meter. Then this is the right angle triangle. You can observe this is the right angle triangle from the Pythagoras theorem. Based upon these two side values, we can find out this hypotenuse value. Okay, the length of the third element can be calculated by L3 equal to under root of 40 square plus 30 square. Then you will get 50 as the value, that is meter, that is the length of the third element. Okay, what he given, Young's modulus equal, the Young's modulus equal to 29.5 into 10 power 6 newton per meter square, and the area is 1 meter square. Okay, in this diagram there is a two point loads acting at node 2 and node 3. Here the point load act downwards. Okay, the load of 25,000 okay newtons. Then at At node 2, there is a horizontal direction force of 20,000 Newton. Okay, this is the given figure. Okay, all the parameters you can must observe firstly. Okay, then what is the first step in this problem is, first of all, we have to write the element connectivity table. Okay, then you have to draw this table element nodes 1 and 2. These 1 and 2 indicates the starting node of the element and ending node of the element. Okay, then in this figure how many elements are there? Element 1, element 2, element 3, element 4. Okay, then you have to indicate the element number 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, first you have to select the element number 1, then from the diagram element number 1, what is the nodes of element number 1? Node 1 and node 2. These are the two nodes of the element number 1. So you have to indicate the at element number 1, first starting node is 1 and ending node is 2. Okay, then you have to select the second element from the diagram. Here this is the second element. This is the second element. What is the nodes of second element 2 and 3? Starting is 2, ending is 3. We have to move in this direction. Okay, you have to consider this direction. Okay, 2 and 3. 2 is the starting node and 3 is the ending node of the element number 2. Hence, you have to indicate the 2 and 3 at nodes corresponding to element number 2. Okay, then element number 3. You have to select the element number 3. From this diagram, element number 3 is this. Okay, this is the element number 3. Here there is a two possibilities. You can move in this direction or in this direction. In this problem we consider this direction. Okay, 3 to 1. Okay, then starting node is 3, ending node is 1. Okay, then you have to indicate the starting node is 3, ending node is 1. Then what next element is 4. From element number 4, this is the direction you have to consider. From the figure, starting node is 3, ending node is 4. Okay, that's why you have to indicate starting node is 3 and ending node is 4. Then next step is nodal point table. Next is nodal point table. Nodal point table. Here you have to indicate nodes and x and y values. Okay, then here from the diagram you have to consider this is the origin, means 0, 0. Okay, this is the origin. You have to consider this is 0, 0. Here there is a distance of 40, so x equal to 40 and y distance is 0, so 40, 0. Okay, next here the distance of x along x axis is 40 and distance along y axis is 30, so node 3 is 40, 30. Okay, then here you consider x is 0. Okay, along x axis the value is 0, what is the vertical distance, means along y axis the distance is 30, so 0, 30. Here 0, 0, 40, 0, 40, 30, 0, 30. That values you have to indicate at first element there is a x equal 0, y equal 0, so x equal 0, y equal 0. Next, second node 40, 0. Second node x equal 40, y equal 0. At third node 40, 30. At third node x equal 40, y equal 30. At fourth node 0, 30. At fourth node 0, x equal 0, y equal 30. The next step is direction cosine table. In this direction cosine table we have to find out the c value and s value, where c equal to x2 minus x1 by l, s equal to y2 minus y1 by l. Okay, first of all we have to consider the element number 1. Okay, element number 1. Okay, this is the direction cosine table. This is the nodal point table. We have already written this nodal point table. Okay, how to prepare the direction cosine table means, which you have to indicate the element number and c equal to x2 minus x1 by l and s equal to y2 minus y1 by l. okay, this formulas you have to remember. Next, first element, you have to select the first element from the diagram. First element having the node numbers 1 and 2, okay, having the node numbers 1 and 2. Come to here, 1 and 2 nodes, okay, this is the x1, this is the x2, this is the y1, this is the y2, okay, here, first element, x2 minus x1 means 40 minus 0 by length of the element is 40 meter, okay, then you have to keep value 1, means the result of this value is 1, okay, next, y means here, you can observe this is the y value, y is 0, x is 0, 0 minus 0 means 0, otherwise you have considered this only, 0 minus 0, 0 minus 0 means 0, 0 by length or anything means 0, so you have to put 0 here, okay, then consider the second element, what is the second element nodes, 2 and 3 are the nodes of the second element, okay, then here 2 and 3 nodes, this is the x1, this is the x2, this is the y1, this is the y2, okay, x2 minus x1 means 40 minus 40 means how much, 0, 0 by anything means 0, so you have to keep here 0, c value is 0, then 30 minus 0 means 30 by length of second element is, you have to observe that length of second element is 30 meter. So 30 by 30 means 1. This is the 1. Okay. Next, you have to write element number 3. What is element number 3? Element number 3 having nodal number 3 and 1. Okay. That is the direction here. Downwards. Okay. Starting node is 3. Ending node is 1. So from this table, starting node is 3, ending node is 1, okay, so this is the x1, this is the x2, starting x1, ending x2, next y1, y2, okay, x2 minus x1 means minus 40, 0 minus 40 into minus 40, then by length of the element how much, 50, okay, minus 40 by 50 means 0.8, next 0 minus 30 by 50 means 0 minus 0.6, this is the value of the third element, okay, next fourth element, this is the fourth element, starting node is 3, ending node is 4, 3 and 4, this is the x1, this is the x2, y1, y2, okay, x2 minus x1 means minus 40 divided by length of the fourth element is 40, so 40 divided by 40 means minus 1, okay, then 30 minus 30 means 0, 0 by anything means 0, you have to keep 0 here. After completing this direction cosine table, you have to write the element stiffness matrix for the each element. Here, this is the first bit they asked in the question. Okay, element stiffness matrix. Okay, here KE equal to the formula. KE means element stiffness of each element equal to AE by L. C square CS minus C square minus CS, CS S square minus CS minus S square, minus C square minus CS C square CS, minus CS minus S square minus CS S square. To remember this matrix, I have small tricky, okay, that is, first of all, you have to keep AE by L as it is, okay, remember this one, AE by L, okay, next, open the bracket. You have to remember these two also, C square CS, okay, C square and CS, then you have to, this is the positive signs, next these two are having positive signs, next these two are comes in negative sign, okay, minus C square minus CS, okay, this is the first row, you have to write the first column first, okay, CS here, minus C square, minus CS. The next step is, you have to write the, here C square is there, here you have to write S square, okay, then, these are two are having the positive signs, then it will come in negative signs, minus CS, minus S square, okay, then, you have to write the second row as the second column. Already CSV is there, next SQL is there, then two values are write in this second column. Okay, minus CS minus SSQL. Next, these two values are having the negative signs. You have to keep it as a positive sign. Okay, C square CS. Then this CS is comes here. Okay, otherwise here minus CS and minus S square is there. These two are having the negative signs. Convert these two are having into the positive sign. Here minus CS is there. This is written as CS, and minus S square is there. Here write as a S square. This is the matrix. This is a simple trick to remember this matrix. Okay, after writing the formula, okay, the next step is find out the element stiffness matrix of element 1 is A1 E1 by L1 C square. This is the matrix same as to the above. Okay, then you have to submit the values of area 1 and Young's modulus by length of the element. Okay, then here the C square value, this is the first element matrix. You have to go to the direction cosine table. Okay, yeah, this is the direction cosine table you have already written. For the first element, C value is 1 and S value is 0. Okay, C value is 1, S value is 0. Then you have to submit that C equal to 1 and S equal to 0 in this matrix. The matrix will look like this. Okay, after solving this values, you have some value, that is after calculating that value, you got this value 0.73 into 10 power 6. This is the matrix. Okay, keep 10 power 6 outside. This 0.73 is multiplied with the entire matrix, then the matrix will look like 10 power 6, 0.730. okay, where the ones are there, that places 0.73 will came. The remaining matrix is same. This is the element stiffness matrix for the first element. Okay, from the figure there is a q1 q2 q3 q4. Okay, here q1 q2 q3 q4. So you have to write 1 2 3 4 right top and right side also 1 2 3 4. Okay, to convert this into the homogeneous matrix, you have to write the first of all 10 power 6 as it is and open the bracket. First of all, you have to indicate the nodes numbers or displacement numbers at top 1 2 8, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, as well as right side also. Okay, then in this first element, you have only 1 2 3 4 displacements. Okay, there is no 4 5 6 7 8, so you have to keep all the 5 6 7 8 columns and 5 6 7 8 rows as 0. Okay, then the remaining matrix is there, the remaining space, you have to fill that space with this matrix. Okay, this is the K matrix. After finding out the K1 value, the second matrix is K2, AE by A2 E2 by L2. This is the matrix is same for any element. Okay, this is the value given in the problem. You have to submit this value, then you got the value of 0.98 into 10 power 6. From the direction cosine table, you got the C value and this S value. Okay, that value substituted in this equation, in this matrix, you get matrix this like. Okay, then you have to keep the 10 power 6 outside, then 0.98 is multiplied with the entire matrix, then you will got this matrix. Okay, then in the second element, you have 3 4 5 6, means q3 q4 q5 q6 element. Okay, so you have to indicate the 3 4 5 6 and 3 4 5 6 top and right side as well. As then to convert this into homogeneous matrix, same as k1, k2 equal 10 power 6, then open the bracket, keep all the 8 numbers top and right side. Then here you have 3 4 5 6, there is no 1 2 and 7 8, so you have to keep 1 and 2 and 7 and 8 columns are 0, as well as 1 and 2 rows and 7 and 8 rows as well as 0. Okay, the remaining things that is filled with this matrix. Okay, this is a matrix, K matrix of second element. The third matrix formula is same as the K1 and K2. Okay, the values are taken from the These values are taken from the direction cosine table. Okay guys, then this is the value calculated. This value is calculated gives the value of 0.59 into 10 power 6. The 10 power 6 is keep outside, and 0.59 multiplied with this matrix, you got this these values. Okay, then go to the third element from the diagram. Here this is the third element. You consider the direction as downwards. Okay, means q5 q6 q1 q2. First of all, you have to write q5 q6 q1 q2. Otherwise you have to, if you consider the direction this side upward, then you have to consider q1 q2 then q5 q6. But in this problem we consider this only. So first of all you have to indicate the q5 6 5 6, then 1 2. Okay, so hence here the 5 6 and 1 2 is indicated top and right side. Okay, based upon the diagram and consider direction. Okay, then next this converted into homogeneous. K3 equal to 10 power 6 is count remaining. Then open the bracket. 1 2 3 1 2 8 numbers are placed at top and right side as. Okay, then you have here 5 6 1 2 is there. There is no 3 4 and 7 8. So first of all you have to keep 3 4 and 7 8 columns are 0. Then 3 4 and 7 8 columns are 0. Then here you can observe this is the fifth column, fifth row, value is 0.37. You must have placed the value at corresponding position only. Fifth row, fifth column, fifth row, here only you have to indicate the first value. Next, here this is the 1 1 value, first column, first row value. Here check 1 1 1 1 where it is. 1 first column, 1 first row. This is the 0.37 here. Okay, 0.37. next, this is the value. What is the value? 6 2. Okay, 6 2, and how much? Minus 0.21. here sixth column, here second row, how much value? Minus 0.21. similarly all the values are placed at corresponding positions. Okay, then you will get the K3 matrix. After finding out the K3, this is the K4 matrix. Okay, similarly same above process for this step also. Okay, then you got this value. Here the element having the nodal numbers is 3 and 4, and displacements is q5 q6 and q7 q8. So 5 6 7 8 is the, you have to indicate the top and the right side of the matrix. Okay, then this is also similar process to convert it into homogeneous matrix. Okay, 10 power 6 keep outside, then this is the nodal numbers or displacement numbers, you have to indicate top and right side. Here there is a 5 6 7 8, there is no 1 2 3 4, so you have to keep 1 2 3 4 as a zeros column. Next rows also 1 2 3 4. Okay, this 4 rows are so 0. Then the remaining thing is there, that place is placed with or replaced with this matrix. Okay, up to the K4 there the first bit is completed, and second bit is assemble the stiffness matrix, means global stiffness matrix. This is the second bit. Here K equal to K1 plus K2 plus K3 plus K4. Okay, here you have to write K equal 10 power 6 is there in all the matrices K1, K2, K3, K4. So you have to keep outside, then open the bracket. Okay, keep all the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 number up to 8 on top side and right side. Okay, right side of the matrices. Then you have to observe the K1, K2, K3, K4 matrices. That is a 1 1. First column, first row value, how much? Okay, means in K1, means in K1 1 1 value is 0.73, in K2 1 1 value is 0, in K3 0.37, in K4 0. So add this all the values, you will get to 1.1. Okay, 1.1. Similarly from K1 to K1, K2, K3, K4 matrices, you will get all the values and combine them to get this matrices. Okay, this is the K matrix. Okay guys, up to now we completed the element stiffness matrix of each element and global stiffness matrix of the entire thing. Okay, The remaining thing will continue in the next class. Okay, next video. Please subscribe my channel and like and share this video to your friends and